I did not have time yet to make a good manual, or a manual at all actually, for Pine Mashup. Reason is I mainly use it myself, but it's open source, so if you want to use it or want to contribute, please feel free to do so. The program now contains two parts. One is a Python script based part to make meshes, and the other one on the part is a part to run Capitan with the mesh that was just created. The idea is you type some Python code here, you run it with this button, and then you get either you get an error or you get your volumes here. There's a number of examples included, so we go to examples and open. We automatically open the example folder. If you don't want to use the examples, the first thing you should do is set your work folder. So file set work folder, and I will just point it to the examples directory in this case. Select. So basically, you can load either an STL or an OBJ file or anything else that is supported by MeshLab using load. So shape is load. So rubberduck.obj is in the work folder. If I run it, it will load the shape, it will put it into the variable shape, and it will display it here. And what I can do is I can use this shape variable as basis for my mesh. I can move it, for example. So if I do shape.move, let's move it 3 units down. If I do this, it doesn't do anything. I need to assign the results to something. So moved equals that. Run. And now I have my second rubber duck. Well, it's a bit small, so I will scale it up as well. Scale, and I need to provide the three axes, so 10, 10, and 10. Or I can first scale it and then move it up or down in this case. And then we have it here. I can press W to show the wireframe. Well, let's say that this is more or less what we want. Then I can, well, let's move it down a little bit more. Then I can cut it at the water plane. So cut at waterline. So equals moved dot cut at waterline. So let's uncheck these two. So this is only the submerged part of the duck. And then I only want it's asymmetrical, so I only want to have the starboard or port side. So one side equals merge dot cut at XZ. Oh, that's only the front, or only the back, I don't know. So we need to rotate it as well. Z equals 90. That's better. So now we have one side only. The next thing is to mesh it. Well, this mesh is actually not that bad, but let's say we want to remesh it just for the sake of demonstration. So mesh equals one side. The should be one side. Dot regrid. So now we get the mesh. It's a nice triangular mesh. Now, if this is too fine, then you can play with a parameter called PCT. Percentage, I guess, was 5. So it gives us this mesh, I can also throw in some iterations. Oh. Typo. Should make it a little bit better. I don't really see the difference. Anyway, let's assume that this is okay as it is. So you select the one you want to save. You click Save Selected, and it will save it as, or in your current working folder, using this name. So it's mesh.stl. I copy that, go to Capitan. It asks for a mesh. Well, guess what? That's what we just copy-pasted. Needs a name, Donald. Give it some periods. By default, it's this range, but you can give any Python range you like. 2, 3 seconds, headings, same, 0, 45 and 90, for example. Water depth, yes, let's just leave it as infinite, and I need to check that it's symmetric. And then I can say show mesh, or just go. Just do go. I'll first display the mesh from Capitan. I hope this shows up on the recording, by the way. Quit. And now it will run the calcs and save them. What's a pretty coarse mesh. So just for reference, it will plot the damping. It will plot the added mass. The force audio phase. And the force audio amplitudes, and it also saves the results files as NC, so that's a NetCDF and a Manfrotto database. That's it. It's well, quick and dirty, but it's very easy. Oh, before I forget, I didn't make any of this myself. The whole meshing and combinations is all MeshLab. Capitan, of course, is Capitan. The GUI is, well, Qt 6, and the 3D is VTK with Vado. I only put it together. One of the examples also shows you how to make a hull from frames. So that's actually using this part. In this case, it makes a nice barge. And there is some work ongoing to make an importer for GHS files, which works, but I don't have any example files to include. Okay, well, that's it. Good luck. If you have any questions, drop them in this forum or on GitHub or anywhere. Thanks and good luck. Oh, and if you make anything nice, share it as well.